Welcome to my Insight Talk at the PCST2020+1. My name is Christian Humm. I'm a researcher at the Karlsruhe Institute of Technology in the Department of Science Communication. Today, I will talk about exclusion in science communication. This problem has gained attention in the last years and more research is focused on it. Today, it is clear that science communication, at least in the West, often reaches only a very specific part of the population that is typically white, male, academic, and better earning. However, there is still a lack of systematic approaches regarding the underlying factors that cause exclusion. Thus, my colleagues Philipp Schrögel and Annette Lesmermann and me developed a typology of exclusion factors in science communication. Through a systematic literature review in science communication research and other fields like disability studies, adult education or political science, we were able to identify and describe 31 factors. We split them in three dimensions: individual, social, and structural factors. As you can see, the typology includes factors like language barriers, gender, habitus, or place. Unfortunately, I don't have the time to explain these factors here in detail. In order to empirically test the typology and its factors, we use the combined quantitative and qualitative approach. Quantitatively, we analyze the survey Wissenschaftsbarometer, Science Barometer in English, for the years 2017, 18, and 19. The survey is representative for the German population. In our analysis, we looked for connections between exclusion factors found in the survey, like age, and different indicators, like visits to public lectures or interest in science. Statistical analysis, regression analysis, show that proximity to science, that is knowing a scientist or working in science, is a strong explanatory factor. Education, age, gender, and income are also significant for some indicators. In contrast, migration background and religiousness are only seldom significant, which might be a bit surprising. Taken together, these exclusion factors are especially influential for cognitive indicators, that are indicators about doing something like visiting a museum or going to a public lecture. To gain qualitative insight into the typology, we conducted three case studies with underrepresented audiences that were residents of a marginalized city quarter, vocational students in a craft, and young Muslims with a migration background. We did interviews and focus groups with them to identify the relevance of exclusion factors. All three groups were interested in science but hardly consumed science communication. As reasons for that, they mentioned, on the one hand, material factors like lack of local offerings and infrastructure, missing financial and time resources, as well as language barriers. On the other hand, emotional factors were relevant too. They were fear, frustration, and insecurity, often originating from experiences in school, emotional and habitual distance towards science, as well as self and external perception of not being a science person. You can find our more detailed analysis in the article on the slide. To sum up my insight talk, the typology of exclusion factors in science communication remains a work in progress and is absolutely open for discussion. First, empirical tests with quantitative and qualitative methods are promising. However, not all factors have been tested for their relevance and their usability in research. We hope that the typology can both serve researchers in analyzing exclusion in science communication, as well as practitioners in self-reflecting their own work, and thus lead to more inclusive science communication. In order to make the typology accessible especially to practitioners, we created a hidden object picture, of which you can see a detail on the slide. On the picture, exclusion factors are visually illustrated and accompanied by short explanations. You can download it for free via the link or order a free copy by emailing me. And that's it. Thank you for your attention.